Good morning, students. In this video, I will read and explain you the story of the power of unity. I'll explain the moral of the story. Everyone open page number 25. Once upon a time, there lived a flock of doves, a group of doves. One day, they were flying in search of food. They flew for a long time, but they couldn't get anything to satisfy, that is, fulfill their hunger. Means one day, a group of doves who were very hungry, they flew from one place to another in search of food, but they didn't get anything which could satisfy their hunger. Suddenly, they found some rice scattered under a tree. Scattered means spread over a small area or a large area. So, all the doves landed and began to eat the rice. You know, birds were very hungry. So, as soon as they found some rice scattered or spread on the ground, everybody landed there and started to eat the rice. Suddenly, a net fell over them and they were all trapped, all caught. Who must have thrown the net? A hunter who was in search of some hunt, and he has spread all this net to catch hold of those doves. They saw a hunter approaching, coming near with a basket. Why? To take those doves in his basket. The doves desperately means in an angry way, fluttered their wings trying to get out, but it was of no use as the doves were caught or trapped in the net. They were unable to fly high, or they were not able to fly and get escaped. The leader of the group had an idea. Now, a leader out of those doves had an idea. What was the idea? He advised all the doves to fly up together carrying the net with them. Means all the doves will fly together carrying the net and moving to a safer place. Even dove picked up a portion of the net and together they flew off. Listening to the leader, all the doves picked up their portion of the net which were over them, and all of them together flew off. The hunter could only look up in astonishment, in great surprise. What happened? I have thrown the net, but I am not able to catch them because they have all flown away. They flew to the house of a mouse who was also a friend of the leader. Now, where did they landed? Near the house of a mouse. The leader requested the help of the mouse. Now, why? What could the mouse could do? The mouse will bite and cut the net and will rescue them. The mouse agreed to help them. He cut the net and one by one all the doves were freed. The doves thanked the mouse for the help. He said, "It is a reward for your unity." The doves thanked the mouse to free them. But the mouse said, "You could be free because you all were in unity. So this is your freedom is the reward for your unity." What is the message of the story? Write it in your words. Help others and live in unity. As I completed your lesson number 6, Indian Social Values, let's move to the exercises. So everyone open page number 27. Why do we judge ourselves lucky and privileged? We are lucky to be born in a great nation like India. What do you understand by democracy and secularism? Democracy is a system of government in which people choose their leaders or rulers by voting. Secularism means all the religions have equal status in India. Explain the term unity in diversity. It is used to show the unity between group of individuals from different religion, race, culture and traditions. What is the responsibility of an Indian citizen? To protect, preserve and promote Indian social values. Turn to page number 28. Your second question is fill in the blanks. India is the largest democratic country. In India, all religions have equal status. Tolerance is the open-mindedness to accept others. Right, true or false? Unity in diversity is the beauty of India. True. India is ruled by a king. False. India is a secular nation. True. Your fourth question is case studies. Here are two reports from a newspaper. They either promote social values or degrade them. Means one says about the social values, others don't accept the social values. Now conduct a discussion in the class to find whether they are good for a society or not. Now tell me, clash between students, is it good for society? No, it's a bad habit. Young teachers are coming up to teach students. Is it good? Yes, it is good for a society. The students of two schools have engaged in fights. About 10 students have been injured. The timely interference of teachers prevented further problems. So, clash between students is degrading social values. Volunteering students means willing students from various schools in Mumbai have become teachers. Every Saturday, they go to the slums to teach the poor children. What is it? Is it a good value? Is it a good thing? Yes, it is a good social value. With this, I complete lesson number 6, Indian Social Values. Complete your work neatly and correctly. That's all in this video. Thank you. God bless you all.